Hey guys, Surgeon here, and welcome to a new video. So there was a question that came up in my clan chat a couple days ago, and someone was asking what kind of skill cape they should go for like the perk for whatever reason. That gave me the idea to go ahead and make a video talking about what three skill capes would be useful if you were a main account to help get, you know, your other skills up as well. So that's what we're going to be talking about in this video. So remember, if you do like this video, go ahead and like it. If you want to let me know any feedback, put it in the comment section. If you want to be notified whenever new videos come out, go ahead and subscribe or press that little bell button when you subscribe so that way it notifies you when you do it. It's pretty nifty. And at least all my social media and stuff will be in the descriptions of things like my Discord, clan chat, Twitch, all that fun stuff will be in the description. Okay, let's move on. For those of you that don't want to stick around for my explanations and reasoning behind the three skill capes I'm about to talk about, I'm going to put in the description below what three skill capes I'm talking about because people say that I talk too much anyway. So if you just want to know what the three are that I'm going to talk about, it'll be in the description. You can get on out of here. But for those of you that want to stay tuned, let's go ahead and move into this. Starting off with some honorable mentions. So the honorable mentions is really, me and my mods were talking about this and we thought the quest cape is a really honorable mention. No, it's not actually a skill cape, and it's actually much easier to get than pretty much most of the skill capes, but the perk that it gives you with the teleport to the legend skill is very handy because that is the closest teleport to a fairy ring in the game before you can actually put one in your house. So getting that at a very early level is actually incredibly important because it's going to help you get around the game faster, and as we know in RuneScape, transportation is actually like one of the key things you try to unlock. So getting a quest point cape, because you've already done Fairy Tale Part 2, you can use the fairy ring that's right next to it, and it's kind of close to a bank, and it helps with your farm runs. So yeah, quest point cape is pretty freaking good. Alright, the second honorable mention, which may come as a surprise to some of my normal viewers considering how much I love this skill, but the farming skill cape perk is actually going to be another honorable mention. It's not in the top three, and the reason is that when we decided to come up with this list, me and my mods, we wanted to come up with a list of what other skill cape perks help you get other skill capes. And the farming skill cape perk gives you 5% increase in yield, which it's great, but it doesn't really help you get any other skills. Now, if you want to do a kind of a loose connection between making money and getting other skills, okay, sure, I'll give you that. But it doesn't necessarily directly help you. Because of that, the reason it's an honorable mention is because a lot of people do continue to train farming after 99 because of herb runs and how profitable they can be for the little time investment. So the extra 5% that you get when you pair it with your magic secretaries, you get an extra 15% yield from your herbs. Like, it had to be an honorable mention because in the long run, like, this cape's gonna make you a ton of money, especially if you get it early on in your quest to maxing. Getting this cape is gonna help you with making extra money to get your other buyables done easier, or even do what I'm doing and use all the extra herbs that you're getting and use it for herb lore experience. But again, it's not a top three. It doesn't help you get any other skill capes. It just makes you more money. That's it. So let's get into the top three. The first skill cape on the top three is going to be the magic skill cape. Now, what the perk of the magic skill cape is it gives you the ability to swap to another spell book that you've already unlocked up to 5 times a day. Now, it's important that you throw in there that you have unlocked because you have to unlock a spell book before you can actually swap to it, which if you have 99 magic, odds are you generally have them, but if you haven't done Lunar Diplomacy or you haven't done Desert Treasure or you don't have the 60% Arceus favor, you can't switch to those spell books. So just something important to note there. The reasoning behind putting magic on this list is, let's say you're doing Slayer or something and you're doing a task where you need to fire wave something, or you know, you're barraging something. You don't necessarily want to go and switch your spell book back to Lunars if you know that the next task you have, you're going to be needing to stay on the spell book you were just on. So like if you were bursting and then you go and get another task and then you need to go back and burst some more, like, you don't want to be having to switch your spellbook twice. So having the magic skill cape is going to just save you that extra trip to someone else's house or to the altar or to wherever to switch your spellbook. It's just going to save you a little bit of extra time. Plus, it's also handy if, like, I don't know, something I saw on a mammal stream was he messed up, he died, and he needed to get back quickly, but he didn't have access to the teleport because he was on the wrong spellbook, but he had the magic cape, so he swapped spellbooks to get the teleport to get back to where he was so he could pick up the item that he dropped before he died. Yeah, it's just a very kind of clutch thing, and it has very niche uses, but to be honest, a lot of the skill capes don't give you very many perks that are useful in other capacities, So the magic skill cape, even though it seems like it's a very weak perk and can be, you know, outclassed by other things you unlock as you level up your account, it still is valuable to have, and, you know, it can come in clutch in some situations. So for that reason, we're going to put it as number three on this list. So number two on this list is going to be the crafting cape. Now, this and number one are very highly contested because they do both give very good benefits, but all in all, crafting cape is slightly below number one. And what the crafting cape does is it gives you infinite teleports inside the crafting guild. And the reason that this teleport is so good is that it's actually the closest teleport to a bank. So when you're doing things like rune crafting, where you actually have to bank essence, so things like lava rune crafting, it's generally the best one to go to, or the best bank to use, because it is the closest to it. Not only is it useful for things like rune crafting, but also just teleporting towards a bank in general. So you finish a slayer task, you teleport with the crafting guild, get you right to a bank, you get your inventory, and you're ready to go on your next task. You're doing a clue scroll and you need a bank to grab out different items for an emote clue, or you need to bank all your stuff before you go out into the wildy. Crafting cape. It's a very useful cape, as it just get you close to a bank instead of having to teleport to Edgeville with, like, you know, a teleport house tablet or glory. Just having the crafting cape is an infinite source of very close bank teleports. And topping the list at number one is going to be the construction cape. Why is this cape number one? It gives you infinite teleports to your player owned house and any player owned house portal. This is just so good for getting around the game. And as we all know with RuneScape, transportation and teleportation is key to just making this game more efficient whenever you're trying to travel around the world. So having the construction cape just gives you a lot of very niche teleports that you would otherwise not have. So like teleporting to Relica, teleporting to Palmavich, teleporting to Karend, like, it gives you good teleports. And on top of that, it gets you the ability to just get to your house where you're going to have, you know, other teleportations in there, other kinds of jewelry, because you're going to have 99 construction already. So you have your jewelry, you'll have your fairy ring, your spirit tree, your wilderness obelisk. Like, having 99 construction is just a very good skill cape to have, simply because the teleports that it gives you just makes every other way of traveling in the game much more efficient. Downside to all this, even through the cheapest methods, it's going to cost you like 120 mil, like, minimum. So yes, it's a very expensive 99 to get, and that's why, like, a lot of people don't necessarily get it first, but ideally, if you're looking for a skill cape that you want to get to help you advance in other areas of the game faster, having the perks of the construction cape are going to help you tremendously. And that's going to wrap it up for this video, you guys. So thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Again, I mentioned at the beginning, if you did like it, feedback, comment, want to see more, subscribe. Thank you to the people that helped me out with this video. One of my mods, Tom, or Slap Me Dong, I believe is his name. Also, quick shout out to Jiria Sun, sorry if that's wrong, and Alarax for both doing quest point cape emotes for me. I'm a scrub and haven't done the two new quests yet, so I obviously can't do that cape emote yet. But thank you guys very much for your help with that. I appreciate the background footage. Thank you guys again for watching. I know I already mentioned it. Those of you wondering if I'm back or not, quote unquote back, TM. I'm just trying it out right now, really kind of experimenting and seeing if I really want to devote all my time into this game again. I'll do a real life video kind of explaining the stuff that's going on, but I've already done that before, so it's whatever. Have a good morning, night, evening, afternoon, whatever time of day it is, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Have a good one.